It's probably logged by now.
No, it's still in there.
Also, we're probably being flanked by the guys at the barracks unless they server hopped.
I'm gonna make an approach. You watch the little window.
Shots?
Shots.
That's that bloody hunting rifle, is
that? Yeah, that was that pistol, I think.
What the fuck is it firing?
Is that up a red bar, mate?
No, that was him.
Got him.
Yes, there is someone trying to get into his building that we can't see. I'm gonna make an approach anyways. Anyone else?
I'm behind you.
Just keep Overwatch.
Yep.
Or come with me. Whatever.
I'm not coming with you with this fucking rifle. I've got no eyes on any of the windows now. Any of the front windows. I've got eyes on the right windows where you are.
Oh, fuck's sake.
Don't shoot it. Just keep running.
SKS. Shooting this direction. I'm getting pops.
I'm not hearing any of it.
I'm getting cracks.
The fuck is he firing at? And where from? Is he in one of the windows?
He must
be. I think he's actually still in the shack.
He is still in the shack, I think.
I took out the zombie chasing you. No, I took out the zombie chasing you.
He's still alive, the zombie, but...
Oh, fuck, there's blood. Must have hit it in the wrist or something.
Who was that?
Him. Oh, that was him firing, not me.
Yeah, it sounded like it landed near me.
M4?
I'm dead. I'm gonna die.
I can hear... I'm looking up the hill. I can't see anything.
Me shooting M4.
No fucking eyes, John. I'm looking up.
John, do you need...
How far up is he?
He's halfway up. Hit him once. Wearing all black gas mask.
Okay, trying to reposition, but it's slow up a hill.
Dude, why are my rounds going? He's prone at a tree.
Is that him firing?
Yeah, that's him firing.
Is that the only one?
Yeah, seems to be M4.
Okay, repositioning on him.
It's me firing.
Okay.
In the ground in front of me.
It's him shooting.
Fucking ground in front of me.
What the hell? Dean's in the chat. 07 Dean. Thanks for joining us.
This is so fucking dumb.
Oh fuck, I'm right on him. 10 seconds, dude, 10 seconds.
Please,
10 seconds. Fuck, I can see the blast but not his eyes. Firing. Hit. Firing. Not sure about his status. I think he's done. He's done. He's done, John, he's done.
Oh,
are you hit?
I was hit in the legs.
He's him.
Fucking hell. Nice time to join, Dean. We're in a fucking hardcore first person firefight.
In the fucking shack. There's two of them in the shack. One outside on the ground, I think.
No, is that not me? Maybe?
John, do you need support?
I think I'm good. I'm not bleeding.
I'm up behind him.
I'm looking back at the shack.
You okay.
Just carry on going around there. I'm
dude, I'm staying above you because I don't want you to get overwatched again.
My legs are broken or not at the moment.
Dean's joined my chat and he's like, intense!
Is he shooting at you?
John, are you sprinting?
No, I'm not sprinting.
I just saw someone down left, near the auburn trees. Yeah, green, blue backpack. Down and left.
Where?
Facing up. I don't know how to explain it. Down the hill, to the left, there's like a little, the first building down and left of this hill. There's like a little building with a tin fence. Can't see what building it is through the trees. It's a barn, yeah. He's down there, blue backpack, light coloured clothes.
Shit, dude. I'm right there.
Fuck, is that... No, I see him. You've not got a blaze, have you?
No, shoot.
What, one second. He's shifting.
Where is he, at the barn?
But yeah, he's outside the barn. He's just moving around in front of me. Waiting for steady. Come on, motherfucker, stay steady.
Eyes on.
Hold till he's steady. No! Oh, he's hit. He's unconscious.
He's right in front of me, man. I could not shoot.
Okay, good shot. He's probably KO'd. He's probably not down. Don't presume that's it. Okay.
Good spot.
Fucking hell, if my heartbeat monitor was on now, it would say 999. Okay. Has Dean just joined TeamSpeak?
Yeah.
Is that you, Dean?
It is.
Hey, buddy.
Hey.
I see you. I see you, John. That's me.
Okay. I'm not looking at it. I can't.
Fucking intense or what?
Yeah. I'm watching the stream. I just gotta mute it because I'm getting really confused.
God damn.
Where are you, Smithy? Are you
I'm still in the shack, man. He's still engaging.
He's still inside the shack?
Yeah.
Is this guy dead? Dude, this guy's not dead. Are you alive?
Dude, I might need to go check if the blue guy's...
This guy's not dead. I'm bandaging him. Oh, I probably shouldn't. I should probably take his fucking magazine first.
Take
That's a bit extreme, John.
Scalp him.
Wow. Scalp him.
Yeah, Dean, sorry about John. He gets a bit angry. Which guy?
He's up.
Blue guy. Fuck.
That's good. I'm enjoying this.
You can. Do you want the server?
Oh, no, see, I'm enjoying it. I'm trying to cook.
Fucking bullet. He's still there. He's still that big tree. Right, got him. I don't know. I hit fired.
No eyes.
Chris, is that you?
Please look at him, Chris.
I see you, John. I see you.
Where's him? He should be at that tree right in front of me. Big oak tree. Beech tree, sorry.
I don't fucking see him, dude.
You moving?
I'm moving around, aiming down. I've got a black helmet on. How do you not know it's me?
Oh, there's someone at Red Top Barn.
That must be this guy.
I'm outside Red Top Barn.
Okay.
Next to a fucking tree, he's right in front of me.
I see you, Chris, up the hill.
Yeah, John, I'm looking at you, and I've got enfilade on all the trees in front of you. There is no standing person. Oh, wait, you think he's... What? Oh, I can see his legs, but when I zoom in, he disappears. What the fuck?
Eh?
Yeah, I can see his legs, but when I zoom in, it disappears. I think it's a lod bug. I think the root of the tree moves when I'm looking at him from here. I see the tree guy, and John, and he's not moving at all.
Dude,
I can see his white trousers, clear as day, five trees in front of you, but he's... I can't...
This tree, right?
Yeah, he's behind that, but he's not moving an inch. My guy's still fucking awake, dude, I need to deal with him. Dean, did you change it so that if you log off unconscious it doesn't kill your character? Is that true?
No, it should still kill you. Possible it might not, but if it doesn't, it's a bug.
Okay. Oh my god, John, this guy we killed, he's got like 60 round Stanag. No, yeah, 5 60 round Stanag.
Good, because I need some ammo.
Oh, well, they're all ruined.
That's right. The ammo tends to not ruin when the mags are ruined.
Is this experimental or stable?
This is stable.
Stable.
This is also fucking awesome. I'm firing.
Experimental one them. You were on before, the 100 slot, we hit it run on reduced CPU. So
shots?
Me, trying to kill this guy.
It's actually running better. Now.
It feels a lot smoother.
I don't know if you're still watching the stream, Dean, but I can't shoot this guy because of the bounding box thing. This is what I told you about the other day.
Yeah. It got bugged up, and I saw it in the bug tracker, so...
God damn it. See, I'm trying to kill him, but because he's prone, he's underneath the bounding box of the floor, so I can't hit him.
You need to be careful of metal shack, Chris.
There we go.
May actually be better. It's worth testing it in experimental, because there were a couple of bug fixes associated with coordinates.
Oh, okay. So it might have realigned the bounding box with the floor.
In experimental, you can also check pulse as well, which will tell you information about their health and things like that.
Ah, cool.
Can you check your own pulse?
Yep. Oh, no, you can't. You have to get someone to check it. The action won't show up unless the person's unconscious or dead, but if you scroll the mouse wheel, you'll see it, if you look at them, if that makes sense.
It's me approaching you, Chris.
Okay. Okay, so like, if your teammate's been shot and knocked out, you can check his pulse, and if it's like, his pulse is incredibly rapid, then he's probably close to death.
It's like strong and weak. If it says, because I did a bit of research with a doctor friend of mine, so we decided to just stick with like strong or weak. If it's strong, it means you're super healthy. If it's steady, it means you're healthy. It only reflects health. We're going to bring out a blood pressure unit that will tell you the blood. But for the moment, the pulse will tell you the health of the person.
Is the blood test unit going to be reusable.
Blood pressure. Oh, it's blood pressure. There'll be a manual one and there'll be a battery one.
Oh, well.
Cool. The manual one will take time and the electric one won't, I think. But, yeah, you can check someone's pulse who's alive and standing around. You don't have to. They don't have to be dead.
Do you think maybe in the future, depending on what kind of disease you might have, it might say, like, this person's pulse is erratic, and it's like, oh shit, you might have blah blah blah.
Yes, that'd be cool. Already you can get a heart attack, and some of the symptoms of a heart attack are similar to other symptoms like chest pains. There's a couple of things at the moment that give you chest pains. So,
wow, like what, like strain or?
I can't remember. I can't remember. There's a couple of things I know that's there because the notifiers are already being used, and I just reused them. Actually, heart attack doesn't bring up sick. I should do that. I should get it to bring that up in the notifier. Mind you, at the moment, you only get the heart attack when you're unconscious anyway, so you'll be unconscious. So.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, so don't use a... There's a public service announcement. I'm Dean Hall and I approve this message. The defibrillator should only be should not be used on people who are just unconscious. You should always check the pulse. If the pulse is irregular, use a defibrillator.
Oh, okay.
We're simplifying. In the real world, if someone's having a heart attack, you probably won't feel a pulse because no blood's moving, but their heart will still have electrical activity, and the defibrillator resets the electrical activity.
Yeah.
But, you know, you got to make some compromises, and it was getting too confusing, and we were shocking people who were dead and getting really confused, so we decided to make pulse for the moment at least. It says irregular. It'll say, like, the pulse is irregular and strong. That will mean the person's having a heart attack, but they're still, like, they're still healthy.
Yeah. So when you have a heart attack, what happens? Do you get a lot of shock value, so you stay unconscious, or do you get blood and health loss?
You go straight away, you go... Well, no, when you first... It depends. If you start having it as a medical emergency, you'll start getting notifiers telling you that you're having a heart attack. Well, no, that you've got chest pains. Right. And then you'll go unconscious, and your health starts depleting. Not your blood, your health, which is very serious. So basically, you've got a few minutes for someone to... we are implementing CPR as well. So it'll be kind of like Space Station 13, where you stand beside the body, you select, you know, chest compressions, and that's all we'll be doing is chest compressions.
That's all you're meant to do now, isn't it? You're not meant to do the breath of life.
The breath stuff never really works anyway. But yeah, so you do the chest compressions, and it will extend someone for a little bit longer. And that will work for basically any serious health. Whenever you do that, you'll give someone a little bit more health.
Oh, okay. What, like a single unit, like a unit of health, or will it give them like a plus health per second for a certain amount of time?
Just a unit of health. But you can only do it, you know, once every sort of, you know, few seconds. So it'll be just enough to keep the person alive. So if you keep doing it, it will keep the person alive until you can give more help. But we probably won't have it that it will affect blood. So if someone bleeds, someone can bleed to death while you're doing that. But if they're having some kind of medical emergency, you'll be able to keep them going as long as their blood's not draining out.
That's... I'm not sure that's right in the sense that you can have zero blood and you will not die.
No, you will. You will die.
Have you changed that?
I've changed that now. I found a bug where you basically could never die of a medical emergency. It's why people were spawning in and they were unconscious and stuck there. It's because it would never kill you. But I did some optimizations and I optimized too much. So for quite a while now, a month or so, you could never die from a medical emergency. You just stay unconscious. Your blood would be zero, your health would be zero, and that's it. Now, in the experimental branch, you can. If your blood or your health gets to zero, that's it. You're dead.
Right. So if your blood gets to zero, you're dead, even if you were previously on 100% health.
That's right. Your health could be 5,000 because it's measured up to 5,000.
Yeah.
And you would die.
Wow.
You'll die. That's how it is in
that's
experimental
a big change.
Now. It is quite a big change. It
probably explains why the amount of people we've been shooting and they've probably been staying unconscious.
Yeah.
Yeah, two-thirds of people were shooting,
exactly.
They stay unconscious.
I couldn't figure it out because you can tell because the bleeding stops. If the bleeding goes away, they're dead.
Because I almost like, well, I kind of like the old system, where if you